gosh, it looks so crazy.
Ooh. All right, so we're gonna put that back in there for a little bit. We're gonna leave it uncovered. We're about to make Grandma Murtis, Big Red Thomas from Not Fit County, Georgia. Tipping to be exact, we're making her banana pudding. All right, so we got some seasoned bananas. We have some
butter,
milk, some evaporated milk. And then we also have shown the vanilla. We need some
vanilla,
little vanilla extract. That's what we're gonna use to kind of make the pudding for it. You know what I'm saying? That's what she did. And that take a little time. You're sitting there continuously, gotta
stir
mix
it.
That's what she was doing. She was sitting there, you know what I'm saying? I've realized that just recently. You know
that's what she was doing all the time.
Exactly. Yeah. So she put a lot of love in that. You know what I'm saying? She always gonna live on what else through
back.
That. You feel
that.
You know,
exactly.
You know it.
One of my favorite memories is my Pontiac. She copped that for me, but the Pontiac took me through college. And that was like the most memorable, because high school was just like a crazy fun blur of learning life. But college, that's when I was like stepping into manhood.
She was pouring into you. Pouring into you. This is what you need. You need people that's gonna pour into you. She did that. You know, I know.
That's a fact.
We both had the gold cards from her. The gold card boys.
She bought us both gold cards.
Gold cards.
No, none of us really had like bread like that all of our lives. But my granny always had bread. I don't even understand it for real.
She worked hard for her.
Worked hard.
You know what I'm saying? From her teaching me how to make certain recipes and watching her, you know, that's how I kind of keep her alive. And she's always a part of the cooking process for me, you know what I'm saying? Because that was something that she did for us that pleased us the most, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So cooking is one way I get close and remember her the most. Yeah. So, you know, you always all over the place.
Yeah.
You know, that where you got Gia from.
Yeah.
Grandma said,
put that bone there, sit down. You're so jittery.
Well, I mean, we children, we supposed to run around.
Yeah. I cut up way more bananas than I think I needed. It looks so good.
We're on point. We're on point. And our lasagna, oh yeah.
Might be time to check on the lasagna.
Yeah, let's check on it.
Yeah, let's check on it. I'll do it. Oh, wow. That's done.
Oh. To the left, all the way to the left.
Big reveal, right here?
Yep. With getting older comes different responsibilities, you know what I'm saying? And with your position, like, a feel with who you are, people listen, and what are you doing now, you know what I'm saying, with your music, to kind of change things that are important to you?
You know the quote, everybody said, you're trying to let go of childish things, that, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm on that path, but I've always been an old head, because I always looked up to y'all, you know what I'm saying? So in my head, I always felt old.
Grammy, three eggs.
Three eggs, all right. I'm just basically taking everything that I feel like and trying to grow with the music and stuff like that. As a man, as a person, like, I'm just trying to make sure the music represent like how I feel. Waking up in this country kind of make you mad every day if you're black. That's kind of crazy to say, but at the same time, it's like truthful.
Right.
So that's what really what's been going on in my music, just like truthfulness and not too like making anybody uncomfortable. Just like being truthful with it and then enjoying that truth, enjoying like the result of like being able to put your foot forward and give truth in your music, and then watching how people receive that. Like, that's always fun, watching how people react to the music that we put out or that I put out sometimes.
Me being a fan of music, you know, I enjoy everything that, you know, you put out. I ain't being biased because you're my brother, but it's also, I can relate to the message. The influence of different things that you expose me to as well, because it's different messages in there, but also the things that you listen to that I'm sure that you put in your music because you relate to people in a different part of the world. You know what I'm saying? It's bringing that good feeling that somebody in America, in East Atlanta, can feel the same thing as somebody over in Africa.
Traveling the world and stuff, I feel like that's the best experience you can get, like, of culturing yourselves, of getting smarter. Like, you learn different things when you travel the world, when you see stuff, when you learn from other people and stuff like that. Oh, it's a whole different bag right now.
The heat is gonna make it thicken up, all right? So that's what it is, like, you want a reaction. Being able to travel first around the States, but then my fondest memory is like taking it to a whole nother level is when we went out the country, we went to Europe, we went to Amsterdam, with
Paris.
The fam.
Oh, no, this is the memory. This is when I was like, oh, we lit. When mama started praying for everybody in the smoke shop.
Yeah.
Oh. Everybody just sinners. She's just praying for everybody because we end up just getting high as hell. Her husband right there, she's just looking at him with a look of just blatant disgust and drinking tea. Check me out, bro. Y'all don't even understand. My hair used to grow so fast that I used to have to get haircuts every 3 days.
Moment of truth. You ready, bro?
Moment of truth, yeah, let's do it.
Let's get it.
It's the big reveal.
That just made my stomach smile. Go ahead, man. Take the first cut.
I'm going right through there. And it smells super good. My mouth watering, for real. Stay together. It ain't even fall like that. Good structure.
That's a good square. That's a good square flavor right there.
Yeah.
Ooh. All right, chef. Get all that. You want all that access. Give me all that.
Look good. Smell good.
Lord, thank for this food we're about to see. Pray it be for the nourishment of our bodies. May be fruit for your name, Lord. Amen.
Amen. Blessing. Yeah, it's perfect for real.
First of all, I want to thank my grandma. I want to thank my mom.
It's crazy.
I want to thank my chef right here. Thank you so much.
Oh my gosh.
Man, this is amazing.
Yeah, I ain't even hold you. Mama can't see this, but
man,
you kind of bust a little head. You kind of bust mama head on this. We love you, cat.
Remember we was trying to eat the fastest to see if we can get some more? And then you can get the dessert
faster.
You get
second.
Get seconds, and then you can get the dessert faster.
We missing a little salad. All we need is some granary.
Yeah, mama.
I'm gonna follow it up with a salad. My mom would not have
this. She would not have this. Well, you don't eat this salad.
And we gonna throw the disclaimer out here.
He ain't even eat salad. My boy is sitting at the table. Can't go nowhere.
All night until I eat a piece of broccoli.
Can I have another roll? You better roll your butt to bed.
I remember you said that.
What, ma?
And eat like just how we able to like eat and, you know what I'm saying, share food or whatever, break bread. Everybody ain't got the same opportunities, you know what I'm saying? So that's even why we started the nonprofit. That's why what we got going on with the organization for the kids and the youth and the sports stuff and then the connection to whatever they want to do. You know, it ain't even about us. It's just whatever they want to do, just giving them access and a platform.
Right.
That's anybody ever need. If you got a talent, you just need a platform.
That's why I'm out there coaching still, you know what I'm saying? Because that's
we both coaching.
Exactly.
We both coaching, for real.
Exactly.
Trying to bust down this.
I love it. Let's do it.
It's up. You still got some more work to do.
Okay.
You got some more work to do.
Okay, thank you for the honesty.
Yeah, you ain't gonna hit granny level off top, but you could throw a little jab, but she gonna knock you out. This jab, you hit granny in the lip with this one, but...
Nah, I can't hit. We don't hit.
You know what I'm saying.
Okay.
You know what I mean? In the realm of banana pudding boxing.
Got you. Yeah,
this
right.
is a...
That's like to slap your mama face.
That's a banana punch. She gonna colossal cookie you. You know what I'm saying? She gonna powerful pudding you. You feel me? That's just a banana boxing, banana pudding boxing. Just a little something. Y'all don't know about that.
Found a book or two. Found a book at the crib.
Oh, fire.
Yeah.
This is crazy. Let's do this, bro. This is crazy. This is how you know we always been fire in sports and stuff. This is my cousin, Brian Root, bro. 91 yards, 8 carries.
What year is that?
This is 1987. Niggas wasn't even born. You was born, I wasn't even here. This is crazy. Check me out, bro. Y'all don't even understand.
But look at the pose, though.
Y'all don't even understand, bro. Stop playing with me. The head was skin. My hair used to grow so fast that I used to have to get haircuts every 3 days. Am I lying,
but,
bro? My hair still grow fast, that's why I look like this, but I was a cold fool. This is my freshman year, bro. This is like one of the number one running backs in the country. Bro, I was really him, bro. Okay, same thing. I was a tackler, bro. This at Hampton University. Oh my gosh, this is crazy. This Izzy on the front page. We just some front page brother. We been like doing big shows, bro. He was the captain of the team and they just had a horrible season.
Yeah.
Because of Katrina, but he was just a man, like, just being a man, they always come take pictures of the people that's lit on the team, like, you know what I'm saying?
Got, man, look, he ain't even wanna show the he.
Wow.
He ain't wanna show the
light skin. I was light skinned, bruh.
All the CDs.
He ain't gonna show y'all this though. He ain't gonna show your mom, and he ain't gonna show you this right here.
Hey man, that was Lil Barry Sanders, man. First year in football. Championship me.
Nah, I just appreciate this. This bring me like back to earth. I'm about to write some fire stuff now. Like all these pictures just brought me back to, you know what I'm saying? High school, college, all of that. I was just cold. When you play football, you know what it is. You got one goal, bro. And I was on that every day. I knew I was small, so
I'm
I was
do something
mad.
About it. I'm
like, what's up?
It.
Like, any capacity of life, I was walking around with that. Now, I'm like, oh, this is how I can express myself. Football was an expression for me.
Right.
That was me throwing around weight, throwing around bravado and shit. But this, I still got this energy, you know what I'm saying? I'm still crazy as hell. We still on this type of time, but it's just more controlled, and we know what we're doing with it now.
Right. I'm super proud of it, bro. I'm glad that you channel your energy and in the way that you do music. Like, music connects so many different people, you know, from everywhere, and then you can travel and see that effect.
Spread
that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so you get it, euphoria from different, from traveling, from food, from culture, to life, prosperity, man. Hey, man.
20 million.
20 million.
Yeah.